Following our look at arithmetic operators, let's now look at two other types, comparison and Boolean operators. So the comparison operators will compare two values to give a Boolean result. Remember, an operator takes in some inputs, performs some processing, usually very simple processing, and gives us an output. So here the two inputs are just values, it could be any data type, and the output is always Boolean. So we use comparison operators to help construct conditions. We have conditions in if statements, but also in while loops, also in do until loops. And here are the comparison operators. I'm sure you recognize some of these. The top two we can use to check for either equality or not equality for really any data type. The bottom four are generally numbers, although you may occasionally use this to compare two letters to see where they sit in the alphabet. They are type sensitive. So if I was doing something like six as a character equal six as an integer, this would give us false, because they're not the same. They're stored differently. They're different values according to this operator. A similar but different example is something like, well, capital H is not equal to lowercase h. Well, that is definitely true. So we use these in conditions a lot. And for the less than or equal to and greater than or equal to, don't forget to put the equal sign. It's always on the right-hand side. So comparison operators give us a Boolean result, either true or false. The Boolean operators will give us a Boolean result, either true or false, but they also must take in Boolean values as inputs. It's input singular with a not operator. So we've got three Boolean operators, not, or, and and. We learn about these in more detail later in paper two. So I'll do a fuller video on these, but here is just a summary. So not is used to flip true to false, or indeed false to true. It only takes in one input. So we write the word not, it's capitalized in OCR ERL. We write our, it's usually not the word true or false, normally it's a expression, and it flips it to be the opposite. So not true would be false. Boolean or takes in two inputs and will give you true if one or both inputs are true. So it's quite relaxed, only one side needs to be true for the whole thing to be true. So here, false or true, this would give us true overall, whereas and is a lot stricter. So and will give you true if both inputs are true. If one of those inputs is false, the whole thing is false. So to give you a more realistic example where we've not just got a Boolean value as our input, here we've got is correct, must be a variable, and we've also got age, which is a variable bigger than or equal to 25. Well, we can't tell just from this statement what this is going to result in, because we don't know what is correct or age are. Let's say initially is correct is equal to be false. Well, it now doesn't matter what age is. Age is completely irrelevant, because as soon as and sees one of its inputs as false, the whole thing results in false. However, let's say is correct was true, and let's say age is equal to 22. Well, because 22 is not bigger than or equals 25, this side is false. And so the whole thing is false, despite the left-hand side being true. But if age was 26, well, 26 is bigger than or equals 25, therefore the left-hand side is true and the right-hand side is true, therefore the whole thing is true. So we'll look at plenty more examples where we're using a combination of both Boolean and comparison operators. Just important you have in your head a really clear distinction between or and in particular.